Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let's talk about organizing the files on your Mac. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 800 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There, you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. Now, how you organize your files on your Mac is a very personal thing. There's no one right answer. But often I'm asked by people how they should go about doing it, or somebody confesses to me that their files are just jumbled about everywhere in their documents folder or even worse on the desktop. So let me give you some ideas about how you may want to organize the files on your Mac. These examples may not apply directly to you, but they may give you some clarity and maybe some guidance on creating your own system for organizing your files. So in all these examples, I'm going to show you a user home folder on the Mac. Now, here we've got documents and desktop. For most people, I would think you would have documents and desktop actually stored on iCloud Drive. It makes no difference in terms of organization. I'll show these two folders here in the home folder just so we can see everything together. But you probably have those as part of iCloud Drive. Now, the first thing I'm going to preach is you shouldn't have anything on your desktop. Your desktop at most should be used just for a quick temporary storage for a file before you put it somewhere else, say in your documents folder. So all the desktop folders in all my examples are going to be empty. Now, the main place you want to put all your files and organize everything you've got is in your documents folder. In this example, I'm going to pretend I'm a freelance graphic designer. And in my documents folder, I have a whole bunch of subfolders. I've got one for business. And here you can see I've got spreadsheets for things like expenses, income, even a number spreadsheet that allows me to create invoices. All this stuff I put together in a business folder. But the main place I usually work is in my clients folder. And in there, I've got folders for each client that I do work for. Inside of each one of these folders, I may have a variety of different files. For instance, for this company here, I've got an invoice for the work I did for them. I've got an Adobe Illustrator file, a PDF that they sent me with a description of what they needed, and also a Photoshop file. I've also created subfolders that I'm going to use for just about every different folder in clients. So I've got assets and ideas. So ideas is where I might throw some sketches and some different things that I'm using in the planning stages of a project, and assets may be graphics and things that they send me or I download and I'm going to use in these larger files like the Photoshop and Illustrator files. Now in this next clients folder, they're a client that's coming back to me for several projects. So I have subfolders for each project. Inside each one of those is where I've got various files that look a lot like what was in this folder, including an assets and ideas folder there. Another client may actually be coming back to me all the time for updates to the work. So I've decided to create folders using months. So I've got the year dash the month. You can use any system you want. I usually prefer to do something like 2020-04 for a month, but here I've shown it with a dash. And the idea is in each one of these, I may have various different files. It basically comes down to whatever's easiest for you to find things. And you don't have to stick to a system. Just because you've got one of these clients folders set up one way doesn't mean you have to set up the same way for another folder. So in addition to clients, I also have a folder for miscellaneous files. I've got one for personal stuff. I've got one for personal projects. So maybe things I'm working on that aren't for a client, they're for myself. And even a folder here for my portfolio. Now being a graphic artist, I may also have lots of different assets that I reuse. Some clip art, some stock photography, and such. Now, these may be huge libraries of assets. I may not want to put them on my documents folder because then they'll sync to iCloud. And I don't want to have, say, hundreds of gigabytes worth of that stuff in iCloud. So it makes sense to use one of the other folders here. And pictures is where it makes sense to put things like clip art and stock photos. The pictures folder is stored on my local hard drive, whereas I probably have my documents folder stored in iCloud Drive. So here's an example of a home folder maybe for a writer. The documents folder holds everything. There's a business folder for business documents. There's an ideas folder for maybe some documents of things they're working on, but they're not full projects yet. And let's say this writer works on news articles for a newspaper, but also magazine articles. So these are kind of separated up. And since there are a lot of different articles, and usually they're just a single document apiece, there are just subfolders for each month here for newspaper articles. But for magazine articles, perhaps it's broken up into a folder for each project, which includes different assets and different things associated with that magazine article that the writer has to work on over days and weeks. Another way to organize this might be by publication. If the writer works for several different magazines doing articles, then there might be a subfolder here for each magazine. And then inside that, subfolders for each project they're working on. Now how about a college student? So a college student may organize things in the documents folder by classes. So it might make sense to have a folder for the current classes, so classes in the current semester they're taking right now. And in there, there might be a folder for each class. But at the top level, there might also be something like a PDF of their schedule. In each class, there might be things like a study guide and a syllabus, and also different documents with class notes. Notice how that even though this study guide PDF is inside the E66 folder, I've used E66 in the name. That makes it easier to search for it. I don't want to search for study guide and then come up with a bunch of different files named study guide. I want to be able to search for study guide and then be able to see E66 clearly and be able to select that study guide instantly without having to even worry about where it is. Now in addition to that, there might also be previous semesters. When you finish with classes, you're going to want to store all those things. So there might be folders in there for all the previous semesters. And basically what happens is when you go to a new semester, you move the current classes folder into previous semesters, rename it with the year and semester, and then create a new current classes folder. And then in addition, there might be other folders dealing with basic school business, you know, invoices for tuition, things like that. Maybe a folder having to do with work during internships or looking for internships, and a folder for keeping personal files that have nothing to do with school. All right, so how about a home user? Somebody that maybe is retired or doesn't use their Mac for work or school at all. So it could be a lot simpler. I know people that use their Mac for this and literally have no files at all. They use their Mac completely for email, surfing the web. They have plenty of bookmarks. They have plenty of stuff going on in the Mail app, but they don't have any files. But a typical user may have a small selection of files. So maybe in the Documents folder, you would have a folder for equipment manuals. You know, when you buy something like a washing machine or a new camera, you might download a PDF and you could stick it in there. You might have a folder for health documents, all the things that have to do with healthcare, health insurance, and all of that. You might have a folder where you put all of your receipts and then maybe organize your receipts by using good file names with the date and the name of the company on the receipt so you can find everything. It seems like everybody's got a folder for taxes, right? You put all your documents having to do with taxes in there, and then travel plans. You may have that as well with folders for future trips. And then every time you're finished with a trip, you don't want to delete all that information that you so carefully gathered for the trip. You may put it in a folder called previous trips. Now it's important to realize you can also use these other folders for things. So for instance, the movies folder here for this user, I've put a folder called vacation videos in there. The idea being that videos take a lot of space. So instead of storing them in the photos library, this user may actually store them as files in a vacation videos folder, and then it makes sense to put them in the movies folder instead of documents. Now how about how I store things? So here's a look at how I organize all my stuff. In my documents folder, I've got a lot of folders. I do several different things for work. For instance, I've got MACMOST here, and in MACMOST, I've got a folder for each video I'm working on. So you can see I have an episode number and also a short title for each one. So this episode was 2359 Mail Photos Tips. Inside of that, I've got all these files that basically look the same no matter which one of these you're looking into. It's got the same name. And then there's the ScreenFlow document and also two exports, one for the podcast, one for YouTube uploading. And then I've got the thumbnail, which is a Pixelmator Pro document, and then the exported thumbnail is a JPEG. I also have a file here that uses that same name but .txt, which has all the extra information, things like the description, the title, keywords, and other information that has to do with this episode. But usually I also have a notes.txt in here, which all the notes that I compile before making the video to make sure that I touch on different points. And then I have various different files here, like I always take a frame from the video to use in the thumbnail and also another frame to use as the background of the thumbnail, and I store those here as well. If you look at just about any one of these other folders, the structure looks a lot like this. So you may ask, well, what about episodes before 2359? Where do those go? Well, I archive those to an external drive. So I have an external drive just for holding these. And after a while, I take groups of episodes that are from weeks ago and I simply move them to that external drive. Chances are I won't need those files ever again, but it is nice to have that archive there just in case. Now I also make mobile games. So I have a mobile games folder here, and in it I have folders for most of the different games that I make. But I also have other folders. For instance, there's App Store docs for certificates and other bits of information from the Apple App Store that I need. There are developer tools. There are extensions libraries that I use for all of these games. There's an ideas folder for writing small text documents for ideas for games I have, and also an experiments folder where I'll start a new game, experiment with it. I'll stick it in here. It doesn't get to have its own folder until it's actually going to be a game that I publish to the App Store. And then I have a retired folder for when an app is old. I've removed it from the App Store and I want to kind of archive it and have it here. I'll take that folder and I'll stick it in there. Notice how I could simply create a folder here called Current Games and put all the current games in that folder. And that would make more sense. Everything would be kind of at an even level. But instead, I've decided that it's good enough to just simply have all my games here at the same level as things like Experiments, Ideas, and Retired. In my personal folder, I've got folders for all sorts of things that don't have to do with my business. So documents having to do with our cars, for instance. Financial documents. There's that taxes folder. There's one for PDFs, for manuals and such. Anything having to do with the house, mortgage, all of that kind of thing. Any miscellaneous writing. I've got a travel folder here as well. I also have a folder for scans. So instead of having to be meticulous about scanning something either with my iPhone or my scanner and then placing it in just the right location, I basically will scan something and give it a good file name and dump it in this scans folder. And then I find searching is good enough to find anything that I scanned. Also note in my movies folder here, I've got a couple of iMovie libraries. I've got a personal one where I actually use for real iMovie projects just like you do. But I also have one that I use for MACMOST demos. And then in addition to that, I've got vacation videos and miscellaneous videos. So I don't like to store videos in my photos library. So I have vacation videos with subfolders in there for each trip so I can easily find a video that I've taken on that trip. But I also have other videos, things that I've shot around my neighborhood or different events and things like that. I'll stick that in here rather than vacation videos so I don't confuse the two. And in my music folder, I've got my regular music folder like you do, but I also have an audio library of audio clips and things that I've purchased for use in both MacMost and my games. I decided to store them here in music rather than in my documents folder. It kind of makes more sense, and then they're not in iCloud Drive taking up space. Also in pictures, I've got my regular photos library, but I also have a stock photos folder for stock photos that I've purchased and collections I've purchased, and a clip art folder for large clip art collections I purchased that I use when developing games. So a few more tips. First, you can also use tags to help you organize. So for instance, here we're back with the freelance graphics designer. In the documents folder, there are clients. Clients often have invoices like that. And sometimes clients have invoices inside of projects. Sometimes they got them inside of dates, for instance, like this. But for each one of these invoices, what I've done is I've assigned a tag to it. So if I click here for tags, I can see the tag invoice has been applied to this file. And I've very carefully applied that invoice tag to all the invoices. So as a result, I can simply go to tags in the left sidebar, look for invoice tags, and I'll see all of the files tagged with invoice. So I can see all my invoices in one place. Now I also can create a smart folder for this. So under business, I've created a smart folder, a saved search, and that shows me everything tagged with invoice. Either way, it shows me the same files. And all I need to do is every time I create a new invoice, make sure I tag it invoice and it will show up. Another thing to remember is that nothing is set in stone. You could try an organizational structure, and if you find it's not working for you, you can make adjustments. All too often I see people struggling to try to come up with the perfect system right off the bat. That's never going to happen. Try to come up with something you think may be good, and then keep working and adjusting it. Maybe at some point scrap it and reorganize all your files in a completely new system. My system has elements that date back 20 years, but it's always a work in progress. I'm always adjusting and improving how I organize my files. So now that you've seen how I organize my files and also some examples of how others may do it, I'd love to hear how you organize your files on your Mac. Let me know in the comments below. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.